Hello learners, I am Professor Vinod Kumar Gupta. I am a retired faculty from Kurukshetra University, Kurukshetra. I have served Fiji National University also as Professor of Education. Today, in this module, module number 15, I will be taking up on new ideas that can help us in designing new pedagogy as per our requirement at the university level. My learning outcomes will be what is the meaning of pedagogy and innovative pedagogy. Then I will be taking up what are the purposes of innovative pedagogies, and then I will be taking up a few examples of innovative pedagogies from the emotion sides, from the creativity sides, and digital creativity side. So these are the main ideas I would like to share with you, and I think in a brief form my main purpose will be to bring out major ideas, as the script will be with you already, a soft copy, the PPT will be with you. Here I will like to highlight the main points so that whatever the reading material you are having with you, that will be useful to you. You may be able to understand it. The first major aspect I will be taking up is the meaning of pedagogy and innovative pedagogy. There's only one word difference is there. I have read many views on these two aspects, pedagogy and innovative pedagogy. Every authority has described the meanings in their own ways. But I will say that pedagogy is concerned with the teaching, learning, and assessment. This is the three component parts in the pedagogy, that is teaching aspect, learning aspect, and the assessment part, and how these interact. And as a result of that, we take out the output. If we design it in a new way, because the new ideas come up, how these, how the teaching should be designed, how the learning activity should be designed, which is to be undertaken by the learners, and how the assessment, what is the format of assessing, formative type or the summative type, whatever is new ways, if you find out. So it is a new way or a novel way of teaching, learning, and assessment and interaction that makes it innovative. So the novel word or a new one or originality as per requirement, that will distinguish between the pedagogy and innovative pedagogy. Now the second point is, what are the purposes of innovative pedagogies? A few examples. As you are taking the research and methodology course, so this you can serve this purpose, that the educational research can be conducted, or any in our researches this can be useful, pedagogical researches can be undertaken up. Second is that in our 21st century, teaching and learning, our objectives, our goals, our learning outcomes are very different. We are to develop competencies in our learners in a very different way. So we need to design, we have to bring changes, we have to bring new ideas so that our interactions, our teaching styles, our learning styles, and our assessment styles may change. So we are to make such pedagogies, or we can say innovative pedagogies, by designing them so that we may achieve our learning outcomes in our day-to-day learning activities. The third aspect is on a few examples I will be taking up on the social development of social emotions. What type of pedagogies are coming up on the social development of social emotions? The first is an important concept, community of inquiry. Community of inquiry is a concept which deals with three important components. The first one is the social component, second one is the cognitive component, and the third one is the teaching component. These are the three major components which interact with each other, and as a result of that, our educational objectives can be achieved. In the social component part, there is relationships, collaborations part, and engagement part, active engagement in a collaborative manner, and social involvement. And as I have discussed in module number 14, that emotions are generated, social construction of emotions is there. So the social aspects, they create knowledge as well as emotions, and in a combined manner, then we achieve our learning outcomes. In this way, there is a need of the social environment, and that is one part, important component of community of inquiry. Second is the cognitive part, which we are already very familiar about, and we already use, we go more important to the content side, and our brain part, that is individual creation of our ideas at the individual level. When we throw with before the our partners, our class fellows, or the teacher, when we throw our individual ideas or individual emotions, then they interact with each other and they create new ideas and they create new emotions. In this way, this is the cognitive aspect or the cognitive component. That is the second component which is important, and the interaction of the social component and a cognitive component. In this way, these two are mandatory or essential parts. And the third part is related to the curriculum and the pedagogy part. That is on the activities of the teacher, the designing part of the classroom environment from the teaching. So that component has been given the name teaching component, which includes the curriculum designing, that includes the pedagogical designing, innovative ideas you can take up and you can make your pedagogical aspects, that is the teaching, learning and assessment, and interaction design you can decide and make it a new one as per your requirement, as per requirement of the students. And in this way, the third component is the teaching component. And in this way, three components interact with each other. And as a result of the interaction of these three components, social component, cognitive component, and the teaching components, which includes, besides curriculum and pedagogy, other aspects also about the teaching, whatever is the, it's a broad area, and they ultimately the educational outcomes are possible out of this. So this is a broad concept has been given, and this is known as community of inquiry. And whatever I will be taking up further ideas or examples on innovative pedagogies in emotion, social, for the development social emotions, they will be using this community of inquiry idea. So second example I will be taking up from a research paper from the field of physical education, what type of pedagogy the physical education teachers use. Here I found that this example will be useful in using in our other teaching subjects as also, because the steps are important. First, here important four steps in that research paper has been given. In the main purpose is the collection of information about the social aspects of the learner as well as emotional aspects of the learner. The teacher must collect information from the emotion side as well as the social beliefs or social background of the learner. So every time, maybe in the class, maybe within the institution or outside the institution, we need to collect this information. And after the, on the basis of the collection of the information on the social background of the learner as well as emotional background of the learner, we need to design. First step is on that basis, we need to design our lesson plans. So we need to prepare ourselves on the basis of this information that is regarding the emotions as well as social values the learner has or social beliefs the learner has, and we have to plan. The first step is the planning and preparation of the lesson. That is first in the physical education lesson, there is a research source that this is lesson, whatever the lesson was used for the research purpose, in that proper planning was done, keeping in view the social beliefs or value systems as well as the emotion of the learner, and the lesson was prepared for teaching purpose. So this is the first step. You can also take into consideration the social values of the learner as well as their the emotional status of the learner. Second is that in the beginning when you start your lesson, then at the time what is the mood of the learner, what is the emotional status of the learner, that is most important. There we are not bothering much about the social aspects, we are not bothering about the cognitive aspect. We should focus more on their emotional aspects, what is their emotional status at this just starting at the time of your lesson. And the third step they have used in their lesson plan is that throughout you are conscious about the emotions or emotional changes in the individuals, in the learners throughout the lesson. So we should never ignore the emotional side throughout the lesson also. So at the beginning, more important, but throughout the lesson, you have to maintain focusing besides your cognitive or content side, understanding of the contents, emotional status, you have to focus on. And even after your lesson, when you should continue to know more about the emotional and social aspects of the learner, so that may further help in collection further information about the social values or social values or social thinking or social and social emotions also. And in this way, that will help you in further planning and preparing your further lessons. In this way, it is cyclic in four stages. So I like this, and that this shows that social values and your emotion, and they are important. The third example I have taken up of the scaffolding pedagogy. Here also scaffolding is concerned with emotional support. Throughout the lesson, beginning to the end, even after the class, even the class hours, scaffolding or emotional support, belongingness, emotional belongingness, connectivity with the learners is important. As we when we construct a building, we see supporting structures, whatever we create, that is the scaffolding part. Here the same thing here, scaffolding is the emotional support, whatever emotional support you render to the students during your interactions or within the classroom hours or after the classroom hours when we informally meet, that changes the emotional level and develops and creates positive emotions. Motivation level is increased. In this way, scaffolding is emotional support to develop positive emotions, which are useful in the learning of the contents at hand. This is another example on social issues. In the 21st century, there are many social movements throughout the world. In the past also, there are many social movements in our history. So there are at present gender issues are there, freedom movements are there, biases are coming up, racism is coming up, sexism is coming up, and regionalism, casteism is coming up. All there are many issues, current issues today. We are not sensitive about these, the implications of these issues. And our syllabi cover these issues and how there are different pedagogies we have to deal with it. For example, pedagogy of discomfort. Suppose at present backward classes are there and advanced classes are there, or one person is critically ill, in a stage of discomfort. One can be in a stage of discomfort because of any factor. It is not the question of poor or rich. Suppose I am ill, I am in a critical state, I am in a discomfort. I can be in a stage of discomfort anywhere or any place. So how to have a positive feelings we generally have when we are in a discomfort stage, status or stage, we feel many negative feelings. How to convert these feelings into positive sides? That is the pedagogy. And this is what a teacher is to take up these examples of discomforts, and then what type of feeling they are coming up and how to convert them into positive ones. We should feel the status of discomfort as a positive aspect, and we convert and we accept the discomfort and for making us better. I can give a simple example. Most of our generation, old generation as that time, they were in a stage of discomfort because of the economic reason, because of the facilities they were lacking at that time. But they converted those situations or the emotions of discomfort into a positive side, took the positive side, and today they have placed up a better. Now they are much better from all angles, economic angles, social status angle and all that. So similarly, what type of pedagogy, and this is known as pedagogy of discomfort. Similarly, the pedagogy of privilege. I'm a retired person. I'm a privileged. I have the privilege to be educated. I have privilege to be a knowledgeable person. Privilege to contribute to the society. So I can render social justice. I can contribute to the service of the community. I can serve the society. In this way, whatever is your privilege, whatever you find that this is a privilege, that I got the privilege of education, I got the privilege to be born in a good society, or this, whatever type of privilege. For example, gender. In terms of the gender, I can say I am a male. I am privileged to be a male, female. Comparatively, so I can contribute more towards the social service. So in this, the way of thinking is to be changed in your pedagogy, and they are to be sensitized towards that you are in such a privileged situations, and you are to contribute towards public service. If you can fight for backward classes, you can fight for the scheduled caste, you can provide for the you can fight for the justice for the women or anyone who is suffering. So global issues can be of different types, and you can fight for the social justice. So this is the privilege, these are the view, these are the interpretations we can give, and this is the pedagogy you can adopt, where you can shift from the negativity to the positivity because of your privilege. You can contribute, you can whatever the privileged situation is with you, you can contribute positively for social service as well as for social justice. Another pedagogy is pedagogy of hope. This is also related with the social issues or your classroom achievement. Suppose you put the student that he feels successful. He finds that I have achieved something, I have learned something. In that situation, he will feel delighted that, I can do well. A hope has come up. What everyone cannot be. He may not be up to your expectation level. But a hope will develop that this much I have understood, this much I have done, I can do this. So in the hope, pedagogy hope, that whatever you teach, a hope must be developed. Hope is an emotion which is developed in the learner, and a delight can be developed. That is another emotion. Or One can also feel shame that what I have done. One can feel frustrated also. So instead of, these are the negative example, frustration, losing motivation. So these are the negative, but we have to develop the hope, delight, and efficacy that I can do something better than whatever I have achieved. In this way, the pedagogy of hope, this is the pedagogy of hope. Now, another example I want to take, the pedagogy of empathy. Empathy is nothing that placing yourself at the feelings of others. You identify yourself with the feelings of others, emotional feelings of others. And if as a teacher you don't bring up your if you don't show that you are having this, you are having the same emotions, identical emotions, or mixing up with the learner, then he or she will reveal the problems, emotional feelings, difficulties, and all that. In that way, that you can bring from the difficult level with the help of the emotions, from the confusion to the further effort side, hope side, and positive side. And in this way, you can develop the empathy and you can develop positivity in emotions, and ultimately the learner will achieve the learning outcomes. So that is the empathy part. So empathy, sympathy, both are different, but and compassion, another word which we can discuss in detail. This is not within the scope. So these are the emotions. Sympathy part is that just you are not able to do something, then I am in sympathy with you. I am in your situation, what is, and I motivate, that is empathy part. And compassion, if I assist you, he is doing himself, but I am doing, contributing further, and that is compassion. In this way, we can differentiate a little bit, and this is a pedagogy we can adopt. This is called as pedagogy of empathy, pedagogy of sympathy, pedagogy of compassion. In this way, the word can be taken light. So whatever examples I have given you about the innovative pedagogies on the social development of emotions, maybe scaffolding, maybe the pedagogy of privilege, pedagogy of discomfort, or pedagogy of empathy. In all these, we can make use of certain pedagogy, for example, dialogue pedagogy, or pedagogy of peer tutoring, where one peer is teaching the other peer. Peer tutoring, or cross-age tutoring, where the seniors can be engaged in mentoring the juniors. That is cross-age, who are senior, but they are in the collaborative pedagogies. And in this way, these are the cross-sectional of all these, that is dialogue pedagogy can be taken up in all these. Within this, there can be teaching strategies. After a discussion on the innovative pedagogies or on the social construction of emotions, now I would like to share with you a few examples of innovative pedagogies on the creativity skills. Literature shows four types of approaches, that is the learner-centered approach, open-ended approach, collaborative approach, and real life problems approach. In the learner-centered approach, where we focus on the learning style of the learner. So it is the pedagogies, whatever you have to see, what is the learning style. One may prefer the visuals, one may like to reading, one may like doing something. So what is the learning style of the learner, and we have to see the learning needs of the learner. Every learner is different. So we have to find out what is the new idea in the pedagogy and approach. So that focus must be the learner development, self-paced. So that are the, this is one big category where the learner-centered pedagogies are to be, and one definitely will be creative. Second is the open-ended approach. Open-ended means where a few steps are given out of the decided paper. There are five steps, then two steps are given and three are to be kept open, where the learner is to undertake those steps independently through his own mind and creation. And in this way, the level of openness can be covered up. Suppose there are five steps to open totally we have designed in an activity, then we can give all the five steps, four steps and one step is left. Similarly, out of the five, two steps are kept open and three are given. Another higher level is out of the five, three steps are kept open, two are given. At the further, four steps are kept open and one is given. And in the toughest one, all the steps, five steps are open. They have to sense, they have to hypothesize, they have to design, and then similarly, whatever the steps you have designed. So openness level can go on increasing. You can take up from simple to such type of things, and the creative skills can be developed through this open-ended approach. Third is the collaborative approach, where collaboration part is involved. In the earlier one, that can be individual level. But here the collaboration part is team work is important. Where two or more learners work together, they share the thoughts, they share the emotions, and they share whatever the ideas come to their mind, and then they synthesize their emotions, and they change towards the positive emotions, towards the better understandings of ideas, and whatever is the project given to them. And in the collaborative form, they work and jointly they create something new. So they are the synergistic collaboration part. And the last one is real life problems are given. Such type of teaching approaches are given where whatever you have learned in the class, some real life problems are taken up and they are the projects they are to be undertaken, they are to be completed only through your own creative skills. That can be at the individual level, learner based, or that can be your collaborative based. But the connectivity with the real life project is there, and you create something, whatever it may be, original, it may be useful and appropriate to the society for learning purpose for the class. The last portion I have taken about the digital skills, digital creative skills. A few examples I have taken up about the use of digital tools, that is robot, educational robots are there at present. There is artificial intelligence robots. Suppose in the language teaching, the learner can have conversations in the language with the robot, and the teacher can make use of that time in designing the lessons or understanding the difficulty of the learner and all that. So in this way, the robots can be used for educational purposes also in almost every subject. The robots or educational robots, robotics, or you can say robotics pedagogy. Similarly, games, computers, games and coding, they can be used for designing your lessons. And the computers and the games are there, they are designed, and all the games are designed in line with your educational objectives. In this way, there are certain pedagogies where we use only the digital tools. Similarly, there are many other approaches also where we can take the help of the digital tools for the development of creative digital skills. Thank you very much.